Hello and welcome to the fourth section in how to create a modern home tutorial series in uMake. My name is Nico, and in this section we are going to continue adding some details to the design of this home and then add some color to it and try and get it moved along even more. If you have any comments or questions, definitely remember you can put them down below, and I really hope that you'll enjoy what we show in this one. So let's jump into it. As you can see here, we've added some sections or some of these kind of cutouts on the lower surface, and we've added this little inset thing with a little balcony here. And none of this has any textures or colors to it right now. That's okay for the moment. We will get to that very soon. Let's continue adding some windows. So I'm just going to, if you draw on any flat surface, it'll actually kind of split that surface into multiple surfaces, and then you can use a push and pull function or other functions to change the color or change the shape. So I'm going to draw a rectangle here. Hopefully this will take. Nope. Zoom in a little bit. Now, one way is I can draw a small rectangle here and then I can scale it. If you double tap on that surface, you can just scale that around. Let's try and have some visual synergy with the line down here. This is like a window here. And then we'll do we can just kind of copy some so we can do something like that. And now for the third story, I actually want to have something that looks pretty cool here. So I'm going to draw just another rectangle. And this one, you're going to see, I'm going to modify pretty, make it pretty crazy. Oh, I have copy still on. Make sure I turn that off. Maintain that kind of energy there. But now, if I come over here and double tap on these curves and tap edit, I can actually modify this so that this follows the curves of the roof a little bit better. Now I actually want to have this a little bit bigger. So I'm going to select, oops. All the points that I need. So I need, trying to use a lasso tool to select both of those. There we go. Move this up. Move this over a little bit. There we go. So we have that kind of nice angled window. And I'm going to actually split this down. Make another square here. This I'm going to lower down. This is going to be the exit to the balcony. So we're going to make this 10 feet and a little taller, 8 feet. There we go. And we'll put one more window here. Maybe copy this here. Turn copy off. And I will edit this to give a little bit of slope to this one as well. Now you can see right now, this was moved. I don't really want that. I want that to still be straight. So I'm going to tap here and I'm just going to edit this so that the point, I can move these points over so they are vertical again, like that. There we go. So now we have on the front surface all of our windows. Let's go ahead and start moving these in. Now for the entryways, I'm going to just kind of move the surface in a little bit and then delete the surface. So just going to use the push-pull function here for a little bit. So tap once on each of those surfaces, pull in like this. And then when you're good, done, I'm just going to delete that surface. I don't need it. Now these are windows, so I'm just going to push these in a little bit. I'll make them about 10 inches each. This down below here, this is going to be like a massive entryway, so I'm going to push this in quite a bit. And then get rid of this surface. This is going to be more of a kind of another one. I'm just going to leave it like that. And then this is another entryway. I'll push this in as well. And get rid of that surface. There we go. And so now you can see that these details are taking on some dimension. Now, as I mentioned here, this is like a balcony. And so I want to make a little spot here. And what I want to do as I work on that is I'm just going to actually make a copy of the mannequin. And I'm going to put that mannequin just quickly on top of the balcony just to get the proportions correct for things. So you can see that the bottom of that window looks pretty good actually in relation to her size. So I'm going to put her on the balcony, and this will just help so that the railing, whatever I do with the railing, it's not like too high. So I'm just going to double tap on this curve here and tap extrude again and just extrude that up to a height right about there. I think that looks appropriate. Perfect. And for this edge, just gonna double tap on this, tap extrude, and extrude this back over to that wall. And those are now complete. All right, I said we were gonna add some colors. We focused more on the details and getting those windows done and this balcony. But in the next section, we will start adding some colors to this and finalize it. I hope you enjoyed this. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback, definitely put them down below. You can reach out to us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, or right here on YouTube. Really hope you enjoyed this, and stay tuned for the next lesson. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.